GPT-4 in big trouble right now. Its secret came out to light. And not only one, but two new models are breathing down on GPT-4's neck. We might get a model that will perform it in a matter of weeks. The first one we have from Mistral AI. It released a new model called AI-Large. The good news is just one tiny step behind GPT-4. But the bad news is not open source. The only place that you can find it is either on Azure AI from Microsoft or the platform from Mistral AI, which is kind of their own API platform if you wanted to use it. The second one, our new racist model Gemini, got a new version called Gemini Pro 1.5. And when I went to read about it, I found something got my attention. And I found that both of this model using the same architect called Mixture of Experts, or MOE for shorts. This is not the first time I saw Mixture of Experts mentioned before. The first time was a rumor around the release of GPT-4, which saying it's built using it. It's multiple model behind just this one big model. Then the second one when I saw Mistral AI 87B, and the final one which made me pay attention more to it is the Gemini Pro 1.5 we just released. But what is Mixture of Experts actually? To understand it, we have to understand what is going on with normal models. In any normal case, we have one model that have just a giant neural network that handle everything. We take our prompt, transfer it to embed, which is just a bunch of numbers, and take these numbers and process it and give us the answer in the end. But Mixture of Experts go beyond this idea and run 8 models under the hood. Think of them as Pokemons. We got a different color for each one of them. They work as a team to do their task. Each one of this model or Pokemon expert and good at something. For example, one is good for math, one is good for coding, one is good for English, and on top of them, something called a gator or a router. Think of him as the team leader decided which expert will get this kind of task, or in our case, the token from the user Brom. And by this method, it's not only reducing the runtime and get faster result, but also reduce the cost of using the hardware itself. And the results are very good compared to a general large model. It didn't tell us why it's good, better than the regular large model. Well, it's already have been proven that a smaller model is specialized on one thing are far better than general large model. So having 8 specialized smaller model in different tasks are better than one big general model that not specialized in anything. For example, Mistral AI have Mixture 87B, which should mean 8 expert. Each one of them is 7 billion parameter. But according to Mistral, they say it's just 4, 6.7 total parameter, but only use 12 of them. And as a gator, only use 2 expert every time when you talk to it. Let's go back to the Pokemon example. Let's say we have a fight and our manager or the team leader will select just 2 Pokemons. One will handle English and one will handle code. And that's it. The rest of the team is resting and not doing anything, which make the entire model run faster because it's not using the entire neural network inside it, just parts of it. This is lead us to ask how the gatekeeper or the team leader know which expert is better for asking our questions. When it's training phase, it get trained with the model on selecting which expert or Pokemon is better for our prompt. So in Mixture of Expert creation, we don't only train the model, we also train the gatekeeper or the gator to control all the expert. And it get penalized if it didn't equally give each expert a piece of token to work with. If you didn't do that to the router or the gator, it will basically use the same model over and over and over again. Will make the concept entirely useless. We're no longer using the entire expert, we're only just using one, which will make us basically, which will make the entire concept is useless. This is the paper from Mistral AI talking about their model, the architect details, and the spare Mixture of Expert, the math behind it, the parameters and the value. This is very good if you wanted to build your own model technically. Here is a comparison between the Mistral 87B and the GPT 3.5 and Llama 2. As you can see here, in different kind of situation, Mistral 87B is winning. In Arena Elo rating, Mixtral 87B actually came on top of GPT 3.4 Turbo and Claudia and Gemini Pro. So in terms of model, this is incredibly good, and it slices as a batch too, so you can use it in a commercial use without fearing that someone will come after you. This example I got from the paper of Mistral AI. It's talking about how prompt that turned tokenization get assigned to a different expert. We have here an example of English code and math. The first round, or basically the first choice for the manager or the router of the model, assigned this part to one expert. Like this pink part is basically, I think, English, and this kind of tokens and this syntax are assigned for code. So the first round is basically it change. As you can see here, 15 is different than finally 31. You can see here it's almost he sent to the most of the token to two different only expert to get the results. The funny thing that mixer of expert is not entirely new. Actually, it's a concept in a paper is even older than you and me. We got this paper in back on 1991 as a research paper, which proposed a system where different network or expert are responsible for learning different bars of data. A gating network decide how much expert contributes to the final output, and both the expert and the gating network are improved during the training. This is the original idea came from 2017. A team of engineers, one of them was Jeff Dean, the Google Chuck Norris, scaled this idea to use it with translation on a massive scale, but they faced too many challenges such as high communication cost and training instability. It means the results wasn't stable, and also the exchange between data in the model wasn't good enough. If you want to get your hands on Mistral Large to use it and try it out, there is a very good website called chat.lmss.org. You can go there and select the direct chat and select the model Mistral Large, which is just released a few days ago. This is the best place I could find outside the platform and Azure AI that you can find and try this model. The second one, if you want to just to try the Mistral 8x7b, you can go to the SDK of versal.ai, and here you can find actually multiple model if you want to try them out. Some of them are gated behind some black bay. And if you want to get your hand on the model itself, all you have to go to Hugging Face, which is kind of GitHub for models and machine learning right now, and search for Mistral. You will find different kind of models. You can here come and check and get whatever what you want from it and find your favorite one. And in a coming video, I'm gonna compare Mistral Large with GPT-4. Actually, I'm gonna basically ask them a couple of questions like I did in the last video, which I think it's a very good idea to compare the logic and reasoning and bias and all the stuff in terms of their model capabilities, and we see which one will win. Finally, thank you for watching this video. My name is Hussam Eddin. You can simply call me Sam. Please subscribe and hit the notification and the like button, and see you in the next video.